Welcome to our channel Box Office Release. Let's start the video now. It looks like fans will have to wait just under 2 years to not only see Scott Lang and Hope Van Dyne once again, but also to see Kang the Conqueror brought to life. The possibilities of what a third film could bring to fans are endless. The Quantum Realm seems to have limitless potential when it comes to storytelling devices. Fans will also get to know a whole new Cassie in the upcoming film. She will not only be an older iteration of the character, but also played by an entirely different actress as well, someone who isn't Emma Thurman. Instead, the role will be embodied by the new actress Catherine Newton. No doubt about it, the switch seems unprecedented, and in fact, Foreman learned about it alongside fans, something that, if true, is definitely an unusual move by Marvel Studios. Ant-Man and the Wasp: Quantumania will release in theaters on February 17, 2023. However, Peyton Reed hinted way back in 2018 that Cross may not have actually been killed at the end of Ant-Man. Instead, the director teased that the character could be somewhere down in that quantum realm. So it's entirely possible that Ant-Man and the Wasp: Quantumania could reveal that Cross hasn't been dead this whole time, but simply trapped in the quantum realm. Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for latest update about all series and upcoming movies. But if Cross is really dead, the film could still find a way to bring him back to life, especially since it'll feature an appearance from a known time traveler like Kang the Conqueror. That's assuming, of course, that Evangeline Lilly's mention of Stoll in her Instagram post really does mean he has a role in the film, and it wasn't just a mistake or nod to his role in 2015 single quote as Ant-Man. During an interview, Peyton Reed, director of Ant-Man and Ant-Man and the Wasp, expressed his interest to make a third Ant-Man solo film, stating, "I think we are all interested in doing one. There is a story to tell there. Definitely. There is a story we've talked about, potentially." In October 2019, when asked about Paul Rudd's future as Ant-Man, Kevin Feige responded, "The chess pieces were arranged very purposefully after Endgame. Those that are off the board are off, and those that are still on, you never know." On November 1, 2019, The Hollywood Reporter reported that Ant-Man 3 was in development at Marvel Studios with Peyton Reed returning to direct. On November 3, 2019, Michael Douglas stated in an interview with Collider that the film was expected to start shooting in January 2021. Thank you for watching the video till the end. For more box office movie, web series, reviews, news, and update, please visit our website www.boxofficerelease.com. And if you like our video, hit the like button and share with your friends. To stay updated, please subscribe to our channel Box Office Release.